हेलो फ्रेंड्स, स्वागत है आप सभी का। चलिए करते हैं 2017 UPPCS प्रीलिम्स क्वेश्चन पेपर GS1। तो इसे हम ले गए हैं इंग्लिश में, तो लेट गेट स्टार्ट दिस वीडियो और जल्दी जल्दी कंप्लीट करेंगे जैसे कि ज़्यादा लंबी वीडियो ना हो गया। ओके, तो पार्ट में कल स्टार्ट करने वाले हैं, बाइलिंगुअल रहेगा। अगर कहीं पर प्रॉब्लम आती है हिंदी वाली सीरीज यू कैन वॉच इट, ठीक है। सो नाउ इट टुडे वी जस्ट कंटिन्यू विद दिस पेपर, सो लेट गेट स्टार्ट। GS पेपर वन है, GS पेपर वन क्वेश्चन नंबर वन। सो स्वदेश दर्शन स्कीम लॉन्च बाय गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया डज नॉट इंक्लूड डेवलपमेंट ऑफ विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग टूरिस्ट सर्किट, ठीक है। सो दैट इज आंसर बी इज हेयर सूफी सर्किट। ओके, सो हेयर इट इज। सो नाउ नेक्स्ट वन इज विद इफेक्ट फ्रॉम 1st अप्रैल 2017 द मिनिमम वेज ऑफ अनस्किल्ड लेबर इन यूपी हैज बीन फिक्स्ड एट, ठीक है। तो आंसर इज हेयर 7400 पर मंथ। ओके, सो दैट इज आंसर बी। सो नाउ कंटिन्यू विद द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर थ्री। विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेट इज रैंक इकोनॉमिकली एट द टॉप बट लोएस्ट ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ सेक्स रेशियो। So it's just and that everyone can knows about it. It's just tricky, not very typical question. It's a tricky question. If you just follow the current affair or current news, you easily get an idea about that. It's a D, option D, Haryana. Okay, so let us start. Next question, question number four. According to the National Family Health Survey 3, private medical sector is the primary source of healthcare in India for, that is also a tricky question. So here we can, that answer is C, 70% households in urban areas is the source of healthcare in India. Okay, now, so next question is question number five. Which among the following statements are true about Urja Ganga project? Okay, so here the option is that, in this such type of question, we need to read the both of that, you choose the correct answer from the code given below. So we need to that correct code we require to here picked up. So question number fifth ke andar, first hai, it is a gas pipeline project, yes obviously. Or second hai, it was launched in October 2016, yes obviously. Or it's run from Iran to India, it's wrong. So option here is B, option only one and two correct. Okay, uske baad mein next one is here, that so question number six. So question number six ko dekh lete hain. Here is a matching list, one and second, select the correct answer from the code given below the list. Okay, list one is industry here and list second is center here. So industry di gayi hai and center di gayi hai, to dekh lijiye isko hum match kar lete hain. Here we get just idea about that which industry related with which center, yani ki seedhe seedhe bhaiya ye puch raha hai ki kaun si industry kis center se hai, kis matlab usse city se link karti hai. To sabse pehle we notice that A option here is sports good, theek hai. Ab yahan pe niche hum log dekhte hain, dekhiye A, B, C, D here is. So, यहाँ पे आप देख सकते हैं कि एक तो टू, हेयर इज थ्री, वन एंड थ्री. तो यहाँ पे ए वाले को हम लोग पहले क्लियर कर लेते हैं. ए में दिया हुआ है हेयर इज दैट स्पोर्ट्स गुड्स. सो स्पोर्ट्स गुड्स वी जस्ट गेट इट फ्रॉम मेरठ. तो बेस्ट स्पोर्ट्स मटेरियल, ईच एंड एवरी वन न्यूज अबाउट इट. मैक्सिमम पर्सन, आई थिंक दैट कि मैक्सिमम पर्सन नोज अबाउट दैट वेयर वी गेट अ स्पोर्ट्स गुड मटेरियल. सो इट्स जस्ट इन मेरठ. सो ए कनेक्ट विथ थ्री. ओके, तो ए कनेक्टेड विथ थ्री, हेयर इज ए कनेक्टेड विथ थ्री. टू ऑप्शन इज हेयर बी एंड डी. सो नाउ वी गेट क्लियर टू अनदर वन फ्रॉम द वुड कार्विंग. सो वेयर वी गेट दैट वुड कार्विंग. ओके, सो वुड कार्विंग वी गेट इट डन थ्रू सहारनपुर. ओके, सो हेयर इज दैट क्लियर ऑप्शन नंबर बी. ओके, ऑप्शन नंबर बी इज क्लियर दैट ए वी नो दैट रियली वी नो दैट ओनली स्पोर्ट्स गुड एंड वुड कार्विंग. फ्रॉम वेयर वी गेट द मैच बॉक्स आई डोंट नो, फ्रॉम वेयर वी गेट द ब्रास वेयर इफ आई डोंट नो. सो इफ आई नो ओनली दैट स्पोर्ट्स गुड आइडिया एंड वुड कार्विंग वेयर वी गेट इट डन. सो हेयर वी गेट क्लियर दैट ऑप्शन नंबर बी इज अवर आंसर. ओके, सो वी टेक ऑन दैट option number B. So now next seven question here is, in which year UN adopted a definition absolute poverty? So it is a directly question from that current affair related question. So we get an idea about that when the UNO is doing something in the current news or related that UNO's questions coming the upcoming examination. So we need to know about the things around of that UNO. Okay, so here we get an answer is B, 1995. Okay, so when the UN adopted a definition absolute poverty on the year of 1995. Here is the question number 8. So which among the following is not a parameter for estimating global gender gap index of World Economic Forum? Okay, so how means here he just asked not a parameter, matlab pooch raha hai jo parameter nahi hai estimating global gender gap index of World Economic Forum ke andar. So wo parameter kya ho sakta hai? Obviously laser se hum log इसको क्या नहीं कर सकते, इस पैरामीटर को एस्टिमेट नहीं कर सकते. सो हेयर इज द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर सिक्स. वेयर वाज द फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड समिट ऑन सोशल डेवलपमेंट अंडर द एजेस ऑफ यूनेस्को हेल्ड. ओके, सो यूएन यूनेस्को हेल्ड on here is Copenhagen. Okay, Copenhagen is going the down of the page. So here is the answer question number D, Copenhagen. Okay, so it's just a news related to the current affair. So it's just a direct question. Which among the following services not provided under Integrated Child Development Services ICDS scheme? Okay, so here we have an idea, supplementary feeding, immunization, distribution of free books and school dresses to the children is provided by that ICDS. But here is option number D, it's just not included in ICDS. Health and nutrition education to 3 to 6 year old children not provided under this scheme. Okay, so this is our answer. 11. Which of the following is not correctly matched? Scheme and aim is here. So which is not correctly matched? So what we just need to find out over here? Not correctly matched. So Uday, obviously Uday. So improving finances of power distribution companies. Okay, it's just right. Riddhe, preserving and revitalizing heritage cities. Obviously it's okay. It's just right. Amrit, improving basic urban infrastructures in cities. It's also right. Another one and last one is here, option D, Swachh Bharat Mission, safe drinking water. It's not right, because Swachh Bharat Mission and safe drinking water, it's just not linking. I'm just also providing all the series in Hindi, so you can connect with that video also if you get a problem in this video in English. So here is that Swachh Bharat Mission, safe drinking water is related nahi hai. Okay, so here we get an answer D. Okay, so now next one is as per the question number 12, as per the economic survey 2015-16, which of the following has been constructed as the Chakravyuh challenge of the Indian economy movement of option number A. So here they just asked with us as per the economic survey 15 to 16, they just ask, okay, question paper 2017, that's why they just asked the last year economic survey, which one of the following has been constructed as a Chakravyuh challenge of the Indian economy. So here we have an option, it's just a direct question. Okay, so here is option number C is our answer, movement of Indian economy from socialism with limited entry to marketism without exit. So here is question number 13. Consider the following schemes and arrange these in chronological order of their launching. A, Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana. Obviously after the election they just started it. So Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana. Second, Digital Gender Atlas for Advancing Girls Education in India. Second, we all know about it, and who just don't know, so just again and again, two times you need to be revise that series. You 100% learned every questions easily. Okay, so next one is Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana. Wait for the interruption. So here is third one is Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana, and fourth one is Mudra Bank Yojana. Okay, so here our answer is that one is A, 1, 2, 4, 3. Okay, so first is Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana, second is Digital Gender Atlas for Advancing Girls Education in India, and then they just start in the chronological order, they just start Mudra Bank Yojana, then they just start the Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana, that is the chronological order. So which one of the following countries joined India and USA in the Malabar Naval exercise held in July 2017? So which is that country here? 14 mein ho jayega, which one of the following countries joined India and USA in the Malabar Naval exercise held in July 2017? Option ho jayega Japan. Option number A is right here. The next one is 15. What is India's rank in the 2017 Sustainable Development Goal Index? Okay, so here is the option number A is right, 116th. Okay, so here we get an answer. Next question is question number that's repeated over here. Okay, next is 16. The first demo train of India with solar powered coaches was launched on 14th July 2017 at option number C is correct, Safdarganj railway station. Again they just try to confuse us, Sarai, New Delhi and Delhi Kent, but we need not to be confused. Remember Safdarganj railway station is here, right? Okay, next question 17. Who among the following Indian scientists was awarded the 2017 Dan Davidge Prize in Future category? Option number D is right, he is a Srinivas Kulkarni. Okay, Srinivas Kulkarni is right over here. He was awarded in 2017 that for Dan Davidge Prize in Future category. Next question 18, which of the following countries was a winner of FIFA Confederation Cup 2017? Okay, so here we just directly have these news from the current affair. So we need to be refreshed every time the current affair also. So that is a direct question. So its answer is option number B, Germany. Okay, so winner of FIFA Confederation Cup 2017. Okay, B, Germany is right. Here is the answer. Okay, now next one is 19. Consider the following statements regarding G20 summits. Okay, so G20 summits. Here is a few option 1, 2, 3. And here they just wrote that we need to read it. Okay, just read it, and after that you need to read it. Okay, so here you got a benefit in less time, you just saw short out the answer. Of the above, the correct statements are, okay, so we need to be find out the correct statements related with that G20 summits. So option one says that the 12th G20 summit was held in Germany, right? The 13th G20 summit will be held in China. The 14 G20 summit will be held in Japan. So here is option number B is right, because the 14 G20 summit will be held in Japan. Okay, it's right and it's right. Okay, which one right? Option number 1 is right and option number 3 is right, means answer B. Okay, so here the 13 G20 summit will be held in China. It's not right. So you just need to be right in the comment box the answer of the 13 G20 summit will be held where. Okay, so it's your question today, so you can be write down the answer in the comment box who gave me answer the first. We are just giving them a cloud. So next question is 20. Consider the following statements regarding the performance of Mitali Raj in women's one day international cricket. Okay, so we need to be related that find out the of the above the correct statements are. Okay, correct statement they just asked with us related with the Mitali Raj women's one day international cricket. So first, she is the first ever to score more than 6000 at right. She scored a century on her debut. Okay, she holds the record for scoring 7 consecutive half century. Right, she holds the world record for scoring highest number of centuries. It's wrong. So here the 1 2 3 is right related with her, and fourth is wrong. So option is 1 2 3. Option number A is right here. Okay, so question number 21, the length of the Dhola Shadia bridge inaugurated in May 2017 is around. So it's again a direct question related with that. We need to be refresh our current affairs, always remember and always try to not rectify it. Only matlab ratta nahi marna hai. So here is that answer is, you can guess also if you have any idea about that. So here is the answer, 9.15 kilometer. Dhola Shadia bridge inaugurated in May 2017 is around 9.15 kilometer. Option number D is our answer. Question number 22, India's first time high speed trains Tejas will run between A is Dadar-Kham Thi, Thane and Kolhapur in Mumbai and Karmali. Okay, and next in Mumbai in Pune. If you got heard about that news, you can easily giving the answer of that question. So there is answer is question number 22, answer is C, because Mumbai and Karmali. So in between that, the India's first semi high speed train Tejas will run. Okay, Mumbai and Karmali. Remember it, Mumbai and Karmali. Okay, now next one is the Shanghai Cooperation Organization Summit in which India was inducted as a full member was held at option here is that Ufa, Dushanbe, Tashkent and Astana. It's also related with the current affair news. So answer is Astana. Option number D is right over here. Okay, we need not to be use any trick, because any trick not work on the question of the current affair related and with the related of the science and tech. So we need to be read it out and collect the current affairs also. So next 24, the host country of the 9th BRICS summit is okay, that is China. Option A is right over here. Which of the following cities was ranked the dirtiest by the Urban Development Ministry in a list released in May 2017? So dirtiest by the Urban Development Ministry list released in May 2017 is Gondar. I think, or I hope, almost 80% of the guys you know about these answer. Okay, so now next one is 26. Who among the following has been honored with the 2016 Saraswati Samman? Okay, so here is Padma Sachdeva Govind Mishra. Okay, so here is C is Surjit Patar. Okay, and next one is Mahabaleshwar Cell. Okay, so Mahabaleshwar Cell got that Saraswati Samman. Option number D is our answer. Okay, so now next one is 27. What has been the theme of the 2017 World Population Day? Okay, what is the theme? So theme of the day is ever asked by the upcoming examination. So we need to be read about that. That was the theme celebrated any day, or like any day we can say. So World Population Day, they just ask with us. So be counted, say what you need, investing in the teenage girls, vulnerable population in emergency, or family planning, empowering people, developing nation. So option number D here is right, because this is the theme of that World Population Day on 2017. Okay, so now next one is 28. Question: a Japanese encephalitis research center is to be set up in which of the states? So we need to be here the news again and again. I'm just because saying that most of the question related with that current affair. So you need not to be ratta nahi marna hai baar baar bata rahi hoon. Aap logo ke news waise hi sunte to yaad ho jati hai, aur waise hi yaad karni hai. Aapko uske liye learn karne ki koi bhi zarurat नहीं है. ओके, सो 28 का आंसर हो जाएगा आपका Rajasthan. Okay, so here is that again another question. The foundation of what is being claimed as India's biggest global skill park was laid in July 2017 in. So where we have the found that India's biggest global skill park. So biggest global skill park we have in that you have guessed through the current affairs or news if you heard that Bhopal. It's C, option number C. The foundation of what is being claimed as India's biggest global skill park was laid in July 2017 Bhopal. Okay, so next another question is, who hits the panel on national education
Education Policy constituted in June 2017 by the Human Resource Development Ministry. So here we get that who heads the panel on National Education Policy constituted in June 2017 by the Human Resource Development Ministry. तो कौन करता है इसको देख लेते हैं. ये भी आपका मान के चलिए कि रिलेटेड है न्यूज़ के साथ में ही. इस तरह की न्यूज़ हमें मिल जाती हैं PIB में. ठीक है, तो इसके अंदर जो आपका आंसर हो जाएगा वो जाएगा के कस्तूरी रंजन. ओके, तो कौन है हेड द पैनल नेशनल एजुकेशन पॉलिसी के कॉन्स्टिट्यूट इन जून 2007 में किया गया है कॉन्स्टिट्यूट जिसे बाय द ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट मिनिस्ट्री, यानी ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट मिनिस्ट्री के द्वारा इसे क्या करा गया है, कॉन्स्टिट्यूट किया गया है नेशनल एजुकेशन पॉलिसी को. इसके पैनल के जो हेड हैं, ठीक है, वो हैं के कस्तूरी रंजन. सो हियर इज आवर आंसर इज ऑप्शन नंबर सी इज राइट. सो 31, क्वेश्चन नंबर 31, हु इज द फर्स्ट इंडियन टू विन द ऑस्ट्रेलियन ओपन बैडमिंटन सरप्राइज title in men singles. Okay, super series, sorry, it's just misprinting over here, there is some problem here. It's a badminton. Okay, it's an, it's not that. Okay, badminton. Okay, so super series title in men single, who got that super series? So who is the first Indian to win that Australian Open badminton? So we need to be heard through the news again and again, question coming from the news. So K. Srikanth is our answer, option number B is right here. So okay, so we move to another question. 32 match list first, and say that here is a list provided institute and second. Okay, so here is a list, we can watch it, what they just ask with us. First research institute, okay, Indian grassland and fodder research. So we what we are doing, checking out the ABCD option is here 1 2 3 4, means why I'm just checking it 1 2 3 1 and 4, means is that everyone is different from another one. So means is that if you have any idea about option A match with which one of another list, so we find our answer easily. So we got that here is institute, forest research institute. So if you have any idea about that forest research institute in Dehradun, so it's just very easily, very quickly we can solve it out within a second. So it is that working the trick. Answer is B. Okay, answer is B is here 3 4 1 2. So now come to the next one, is question number 23. Question number 33, the web-based platform Pratibimba to project government's achievements was launched in March 2017 by the government of which of the government achieved that? So we need to find out that the answer. So here answer is C, Karnataka. So we get that tick mark on this. So next question is 34th. According to the World Happiness Report published by the UN Sustainable Development Solution Network in 2017, which one of the following is the overall happiest country in the world? Okay, so which country is happiest in the world? So we need to be that Iceland, Denmark, Switzerland and Norway. So here is the answer is, so answer is D, option D is right, Norway. Okay, so here we got answer. 35th, which among the following is not including the 10 main themes of the union budget for the financial year 2017-18? Okay, so they just ask not included. Okay, so please read it carefully if you're just giving any examination. So here the answer, export performance, the poor and the underprivileged youth or rural population. Okay, so which one is not included here is export performance. Okay, which one is not included? Export performance not included here, union budget financial year. Okay, 10 main themes of the union budget of the financial year, but they just ask whether not included in the 10 main themes of union budget. So export performance is not included in this. Okay, 36, where was the international conference for peace talks between Israel and Palestine held in 2017? So where the international conference held? So they just ask with us Israel and Palestine about that. So which is that? If you get any news or any newspaper, you just follow, you get it easily. That question, direct question, is just in Paris. So option number C is right, it's just direct question from the news. Okay, 37, the size of the respirable suspended particulate matter RSPM in air is, ठीक है, तो वो जो कण जो हमें दिखते हैं ना एयर में वातावरण के अंदर, उसके बारे में इसमें पूछा गया है पार्टिकुलेट मैटर. ठीक है, तो उसका साइज पूछा गया, उसका आकार पूछा गया है. तो हियर इज द आंसर, अगर थोड़ा आइडिया होगा थोड़ा सा तो आप इसे कर पाएंगे. सो इसमें आपका आंसर हो जाएगा लेस देन 5 माइक्रोन. ओके, तो लेस देन 5 माइक्रोन, ऑप्शन नंबर डी हियर राइट. Okay, so we can tick mark on this. Or next, another question, how many agroclimatic zones are found in UP? Okay, so that is very easy question if you have any idea about it. Answer ho jayega option C, 9, correct. Okay, now next pe baat kar lete hai. Given below are two statements, assertion and reason. Climate change is leading to increase in social tension in India, obviously, right? Reason, the frequency and intensity of extreme weather events will have serious repercussions on food security, obviously. So both A and R are true and R is the correct reason of A. Or both E are true and R is not the correct. Here is option number A is right because everything is right and reason is also right.
There is no government to share your vote. So question number 14, which of the following is the first national park established in India? Okay, so it was very tricky and easy question. You get it very easy. I didn't call it national park, the first national park established in India. Okay, 14, which of the following is the correct order of biological organization ranging from organism to biosphere? Okay, so organism to biosphere, if you just need to be answer number, option number 6 is correct because population, community, ecosystem and landscape. It is right. Option number C is here right. Okay. So it is just an issue related to the science. If it is complete the NCERT, if you get it easily that answer, so there is no issue about it. If it is doing the such kind of NCERT, then short notes you to follow. So there is not an issue. Okay. If you don't have any idea about it, so here is the answer. You can easily note it down or revise that to the video. Okay. So population, community, ecosystem, landscape. Again, our next question 42. Which of the following is not correctly matched? Greenhouse gas source. Okay, so here is the greenhouse and another is the source. So we just need to match it. Okay, carbon dioxide, thermal power station, chlorofluorocarbon, automobile. Okay, so here they just ask not correctly matched. Which one is not correctly matched? Chicken, they just ask not correctly matched is this one, chlorofluorocarbon. Okay, automobile. So it's just not a resource, chlorofluorocarbon, automobile. So you just comment below, chlorofluorocarbon source is. So you just find out that which is the source of chlorofluorocarbon. Comment below us. So here is a 43 question number. Which one of the following atmospheric changes takes place due to greenhouse effect? Okay, so this is which of the following atmospheric changes takes place due to greenhouse effect. So increase in carbon dioxide concentration in atmosphere, increase in humidity in atmosphere, okay, and increase in biological population, okay, biological population, and increase in wind speed. So obviously if you just read out all four options, so you can find out that answer. Option number A, increase in carbon dioxide concentration in atmosphere. Okay, so it is right. So another one is 44th, the decade of sustainable energy for all is the initiative of United Nations, India, Germany or World Bank. Okay, the decade of sustainable energy for all is the initiative. Okay, the decade of sustainable energy जो सभी के लिए है, तो उसका initiative जिसने लिया है उसको मतलब आगे बढ़ करके कुछ नया एक कदम को बढ़ाने का, तो that's our answer is United Nations. Okay, उन्होंने इसको सबसे ज़्यादा initiative में लिया है. Initiative means होता है अपने आप से किसी चीज़ की पहल करना, तो initiative is good. Tragedy was caused due to the leakage of option number A is methyl isocyanate, nitrogen dioxide, C is sulfur dioxide, and D is carbon monoxide. So it is also the news related current affair, news related question. So it's just directly you get an idea about it, and everyone I think 80-90% person knows about that. Okay, it's guess which one is option number A is right, methyl isocyanate.
Okay, so here we just tick mark on this. So if you have any idea about the current affairs, or you just follow any news, any series of notes or like this on a means any newspaper, so you easily can do that question of 2017. You easily find out the 60-70% paper you can solve. So please do comment below you would agree with me or not, because it's just a means paper, maximum paper upcoming examination. You need to be remember that a current affair asked maximum time, and there is a few question I'm just seeing that repeating over here, so you can just find out that. Okay, question number 46, which of the following is not correctly matched? Pollutant and disease caused. Option number A is mercury, minimata disease, cadmium, itai disease, and nitrate ion, blue baby syndrome, and fluoride ion indigestion. Okay, so here they just ask with us not correctly matched. Okay, so focus on that question. First of all, what they just asked, not correctly matched. So here is the option number D is not matched, fluoride ion indigestion. Okay, it's just not matched. So another one is 47th. So we need to move out. Okay, so 47th asked with us, which of the following is considered to be the optimum concentration of carbon dioxide for the natural balance in atmosphere? Okay, natural balance in atmosphere 0.02%, 0.03%, 0.04% or 0.05%. So here is the answer is 0.03%. Okay, option number B is right over here. 48th, amount of rain depends on air pressure, humidity in atmosphere, water cycle or temperature. So 48 is just related with the environment or science related question. So so here we just find out that air pressure, humidity in atmosphere, water cycle or temperature. Is this question related with that geography NCERT? If you just read out that short notes on that, or you just follow any geography series of any classes, or you just take any YouTube online classes, so you have an idea of that humidity in atmosphere. Okay, rain depends on humidity in atmosphere. Okay, so and relative humidity RH. So here is the answer is B. Okay, so now next one is 49th. Which one of the following is not correctly matched? So not correctly matched, so we need to be understand that World Environment Day 5th June, Earth Day 22nd April, Anti-Tobacco Day 5th May. Okay, ozone day 16th September. So here is anti tobacco day on 5th May is wrong. Okay, it's just not happened on that day. So it's just not celebrated on that day, or it's just not started on that 5th May. So it's just wrong. Option number C is not correctly met. Is our answer 49 C. Okay, anti tobacco day. It's not. So you just comment below me which is the day celebrated for anti tobacco day. Last but not least, because we just take out the second part of the series, dusri series bhi leke aayenge, to iska last abhi is wale part jo hai uska last question, question number 50, biodiversity has maximum danger from destruction of natural habitats and vegetation, improper agriculture operation, climate change or water population. Okay, so it's again just related with the environment question. So here's the answer is destruction of natural habitats and vegetation. Okay, option number A here is right. Okay, so have a nice day and all the best for your upcoming examination. Please don't forget to subscribe us, and please press the notification bell also to get a new videos information very fastly. So you need to do that the series if you want to learn it. So remember and memorize it. So you need to watch that video twice. Okay, so if you just seen that a two time, you just learn each and every question easily. ठीक है, याद हो जाएगा, दो बार देख लीजिएगा. और इसी के साथ में आज का वीडियो यहाँ खत्म करते हैं, और इस सीरीज को अभी कंटिन्यू रखते हुए इसका नेक्स्ट पार्ट आएगा. हिंदी में मैं आपको दे चुकी हूँ. इफ यू हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम तो कमेंट बिलो, और जो जो क्वेश्चन मैंने आपसे पुट अप करे हैं उनके आंसर खुद ही ढूंढना और उसके कमेंट करना. ऑनेस्टली आप लोग उससे अच्छे से प्रैक्टिस कर पाओगे और आपको ये लर्न रहने वाला है. ओके गाइज, आई होप आप लोगों को पसंद आया. पसंद आया तो सब्सक्राइब जरूर करिएगा. ओके गाइज, इसी के साथ में मिलते हैं नेक्स्ट वीडियो सीरीज में गाइज.